Dear friends, welcome to this edition of VBS OsteoMed. The topic we are covering is the norma frontalis orbital region. This is part 2 of the video. We have seen this slide in the previous discussion. There we divided it into three zones, three areas or regions: frontal, naso orbital and oral. In part 1 we finished the frontal region. Now in part 2 let's discuss the naso orbital region. Let's see an enlarged view of this region. Now this area, there are three key structures: the two orbits, that's the anterior orbital opening, right orbit, left orbit, and a nasal region. You can see the anterior nasal aperture. Same details, let's try to identify on a normal plane x-ray. That's the nasal region. That's the right and the left orbit, the anterior orbital openings. You see? To give you a better orientation, let's identify a few more structures, important structures in the immediate vicinity. See, there are two sets of arrows, blinking arrows. Two upper sets and two lower sets. The upper two pointing to the frontal sinus, the lower two to the maxillary sinus. Orbit borders. These are the four borders of the orbit, the anterior orbital opening, respectively: superior, lateral, inferior, medial. Superior border, we have seen this in the previous discussion, part 1. There we had called it as supra orbital margin belonging to the frontal bone. We had also covered in that discussion, in this border, which is reasonably sharp, there will be either a supraorbital notch or a foramen. In this case, there is a notch in this photograph. Next, lateral border of the orbital opening, anterior orbital opening. You can see a central circle that's not blinking, dotted circle. There is a blinking arrow above and a blinking arrow below. The upper blinking arrow is the zygomatic process of the frontal bone, and the lower arrow is the frontal process of the zygomatic bone. These two form a suture on the lateral border, a palpable suture. That's shown by the circled area. That's the frontozygomatic suture. Next, the inferior border is largely the zygomatic bone and the maxilla. You can also see right below the inferior border the infraorbital foramen, through which the infraorbital nerve and vessels emerge into the face. You can also see on the inside the orbital cavity in the floor a groove that leads anteriorly to the infraorbital foramen. That groove is the infraorbital groove. Next, medial border, mainly the frontal process of the maxilla, that is from below upwards, and then in the upper part the frontal bone. These two join at the frontal maxillary suture. Let's examine the orbital walls to the extent it is visible in norma frontalis. The superior wall is the orbital plate of the frontal bone. This wall separates it from the anterior cranial fossa. The superior orbital fissure is clearly visible, through which a number of structures communicate between the middle cranial fossa and the orbital cavity. This is a big list. We will go in detail in one of the later discussions on the orbit. Next, just very, very close to the superior orbital fissure, more medially and above it, is the orbital canal, optic canal. The anterior or the orbital opening of this canal is seen. It leads posteriorly, when traced using a probe, it leads into the middle cranial fossa. The optic nerve is lodged. It's an exclusive canal for the optic nerve. The lateral wall has two bones, the orbital aspect of the zygomatic bone and, more posteriorly, the greater wing of the sphenoid bone. Now, that's the inferior orbital fissure, roughly at the junction of lateral wall and the floor. Now, the inferior wall in more detail, that's the largely the maxilla. We have seen in a little earlier in this discussion the infraorbital groove leading anteriorly to the infraorbital foramen. That's the main feature of the floor. This floor, the orbital plate of the maxilla, separates the orbital cavity from the maxillary sinus. The maxillary sinus is right below the orbit in this location. Medial wall, I have changed the photograph. I have taken another photograph where the details are very clearly seen. The lighting is better. Primarily, the ethmoidal bone, that is the orbital plate of the ethmoid bone, forms the medial wall. But right in front of it, there's a tiny bone, small leaf-like bone, shown by this arrow. That's the lacrimal bone. These are the two important bones on the medial wall. There are other minor structures, not for undergraduates, but postgraduates may be asked one more detail. Next, in front of that, can you see that canal? That's the bony nasolacrimal canal. Thank you for your patient listening. If there is any feedback, please feel free to write to me on this, or you can also send me a feedback on the blog that is there below the YouTube video. Thank you.